Yes, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. So today we continue with new subtopic, which is equation of tangent to a curve and second derivative. Okay, so first equation of tangent to a curve. So what is tangent line? So last time I already teach you what is tangent line. So tangent line is a line that touch a curve at only one point. Okay. So tangent line ni adalah satu straight line yang sentuh pada curve ni. Okay, so kalau tengok ni yang warna biru ni. Okay, so curve warna biru. So kita ada tangent line. Okay, so dia tersentuh satu point saja, only one point. So this straight line, the red one, this one touch at the curve this one two point. So dia ada dua point. Okay, so dia touch pada curve ni dua point. So yang ni bukan tangent. This one we call it as secant line. Okay. Okay, so therefore at every point on this curve, okay, so setiap point dekat curve ni dia ada dia punya tangent line dia tersendiri. For example, let's say here. Okay, so if the point here, so here also we have the tangent line. Okay, so dia akan ada tangent line. Dekat sini pun sama, dia ada tangent line. Okay. Okay, so dekat atas ni pun ada tangent line. Okay, so atas ni pun ada tangent line. Okay. Ha. So ni pun kat sini pun ada tangent line. Okay. So cuma dia punya sengit dia tu berbeza-beza lah. So sini jadi melintang, lepas tu dia sengit, lepas tu dia sengit, sengit macam ni, lepas tu melintang balik, lepas tu dia sengit balik. Okay. So akan ada nanti yang jadi menegak pun ada. Okay. So nanti tangent line ni kita akan gunakan dalam topik ada maksimum minimum. Okay. So kalau dekat maksimum, properties tangent line tu macam mana. Okay. Dekat minimum pun sama, properties tangent line tu macam mana. Yes. So dia ada. Okay, sekarang kita fahamkan dulu apa itu tangent line. Okay, so here also we have another example, tangent line. Okay, so the red line this one. Okay, so touch on the blue curve. Okay, so curve yang warna biru ni pada satu titik sahaja. So dekat sini pun dia pun ada dia punya tangent line tersendiri. Okay, so sini pun ada. Okay, so setiap point dia ada lah. Okay. So satu garis lurus yang sentuh pada satu titik itulah yang dinamakan tangent line. Okay. So this one also. Okay, so the green line. Okay, so touch on the red curve. Okay, so garisan warna hijau ni, so dia sentuh pada curve warna ni hanya pada satu titik. Okay, so that one we call it as tangent line. Okay. Okay, so titik tu, okay, so the point which is at the tangent line and the curve. Okay, so the point where the tangent line touch the curve, this one. Okay, so setiap point mesti ada koordinat dia. Okay, so this one point A. So the koordinat of point A. Okay, so sini nilai x dia. Okay, so kalau dalam contoh ni x dia sama dengan A. Okay, so if you have the value of x, so how to find the value here? Okay, so nak cari nilai dekat sini, so kita gunakan fx. Okay. So this one curve ni adalah function y equal to fx. Okay, so dia boleh jadi y sama dengan x square ataupun ln x, square root x dan sebagainya lah. So y equal to fx. Okay, so if you have the value of x here which is a, so to find the value at here we simply substitute x with a. So that's why the coordinate here is f a. Okay, so the f a, so therefore coordinate of a is a f a. Okay, so ni penerangan ni lagi. So tangent line is a straight line that touch the curve y equal to fx at one point. Okay, so dia sentuh curve y equal to fx ni hanya pada satu titik. Okay. So since tangent line is a straight line, so therefore the equation of the tangent line, so we use the formula of y equal to mx plus c. Okay, so y equal to mx plus c, where m is the gradient of the tangent line. Okay, so m ni adalah kecerunan san tangent ni. Okay, so how to find the gradient of the tangent line? Okay, so how to find? So to find the gradient of the tangent line, so first we find the first derivative of the curve dy over dx. Okay, so ni tangent line. Tangent line ni dia sentuh pada curve y equal to fx. Okay, so therefore to find the gradient of the tangent line this one, so we can use first derivative of this curve. Okay, so that's why the first step is find the derivative of the curve, which is dy over dx or f prime x. And then after you get the derivative of the curve, so substitute the value x equal to a to calculate the gradient of the tangent line. Okay, so dah dapat dy over dx, gantikan x sama dengan a itu ke dalam dy over dx untuk dapat kecerunan tangent line. Okay, so after you get the gradient of the tangent line, so you substitute the value of m into y equal to mx plus c and use the point AFA to find c. Okay, so m is the gradient of the tangent line and c is the value or skala lah, dia nombor. Okay, it's a skala that we can find using the point given. Okay, so gunakan point yang diberi untuk cari nilai c, or we can use y intercept. So y intercept untuk garisan tangent ni lah. Sini ni. Okay, bukan intercept dekat curve. Okay. So sini adalah y intercept untuk garisan tangent. So kalau sini diberi y intercept dia, boleh guna. Okay, so ni c dia. So jangan pakai yang biru ni. Okay, salah kalau pakai yang biru. Okay. Okay, so sebab ni y equal to mx plus c adalah persamaan untuk tangent line. So therefore all the detail inside this formula adalah kepunyaan tangent line, dia tak kepunyaan curve. Okay, so kita cuma pinjam function curve tu untuk cari dia punya gradient, iaitu dy over dx. Okay, so kenapa dia kecerunan dia kita gunakan dy over dx? So korang patah baliklah, fahamkan hari tu apa tu nama dia, definition of limit. Okay, ada dalam tu. Okay, okay, so example here. Okay, so given the function fx equal to square root x minus 1, so find the slope of the tangent to the curve at x equal to 2. Okay, so find the slope of the tangent. So slope of the tangent, okay, so slope of the tangent we can find by using the first derivative. Okay, so first find f prime x. So f prime x, so this one actually is equal to x minus 1 power of 1 over 2. Okay, so f prime x is equal to 1 over 2 x minus 1 times by a power of 1 over 2 minus 1, then times by differentiate inside this one. Okay, so differentiate kan yang dalam ni, which is x minus 1, so we differentiate only 1. So the answer is 1 over 2 x minus 1 negative 1 over 2. Okay, so because the power of x minus 1 is negative, so using the law of index, so we can write down as 1 over 2 x minus 1. So dia turun bawah, power of 1 over 2. And then gradient of the slope of the tangent is equal to is f prime. Okay, so substitute the value of x, which is 2. Okay, so slope of the tangent at x equal to 2. Okay, so nak cari gradient of the tangent pada x sama dengan 2. So kita gantikan x ni dengan 2. Okay, so f prime 2 is equal to 1 over 2. 2 minus 1 power of 1 over 2. So the answer is 1 over 2. Okay, so 2, 2 tolak 1, 1, okay, so dapat 1 per 2. And then B, hence find the equation of the tangent line to the curve at the point of 2, 1. Okay, so 2, 1. Yeah, so kalau dia tak bagi koordinat ni 2, 1 ni, so dia dah bagi x sama dengan 2. So you find value in this one by using f2. Okay, so f2 is equal to square root 2 minus 1, which is square root 1. So dapatlah 1, okay. So kalau tak bagi, korang cari dia punya pasangan dia macam ni, okay. So sebabnya seperti tadi yang saya lukis, ni curve, okay. So ni tangent line. Okay, so curve ni fungsi dia adalah square root x minus 1. Okay, so sini x. Okay, so sini x. X dia sama dengan 2. So nak cari nilai yang dekat sini, kita boleh gunakan function ni. Okay, so which is square root of 2 minus 1. Okay, so which is 1. So kenapa boleh pakai yang ni? Sebab point ni dekat curve ni juga. So point ni dekat curve ni. So that's why we can find the value of 1 by using this function. Okay. Okay, so now we have the coordinate 2, 1. So therefore, to find the equation of the tangent, so we use y equal to mx plus c. So y is equal to m. Okay, so the gradient of the tangent, which is 1 over 2x plus c. And then using the point given to find the value of c. So 2, 1. Okay, so nilai x 2, nilai y 1. So 1 is equal to 1 over 2 times 2 plus c. Okay, so 1 is equal to 1 over 2 times 2, 1 plus c. Okay, so calculate c. C is equal to, so ni pindah ke kiri, so 1 tolak 1, so become 0. So c is equal to 0. Okay, so after we have c equal to 0, okay, so tulis balik persamaan dia dengan betul. So y is equal to 1 over 2 x plus 0. So plus 0 tak payah tulis lah. So kita dapatlah y sama dengan 1 per 2 x. Okay. Okay, so another example. Okay, so find the equation of the tangent line to the curve y equal to x square plus 2x. Okay, so y is equal to x square plus 2x at x equal to negative 3. Okay, so by using definition of derivative. Okay, so definition of derivative ni kita guna untuk cari first derivative using limit. Okay. So, gunakan limit. Okay. So, dah sekarang kita ada x sama dengan negatif 3. So, first. Okay, so paling senang korang completekan lah dulu koordinat untuk point x sama dengan negatif 3 ni lah. So, cari y. Okay, so if x equal to negatif 3. So, cari pasangan dia. So, y is equal to negative 3 power of 2 plus 2 times negative 3. So which is equal to 9 minus 3. So the answer is 6. Okay. And then gradient of the tangent. Okay, find the dy over dx. Okay, so to find the dy over dx, so soalan suruh guna using definition of derivative. So limit of x, x pula, h approaches to 0. Okay, so the fx plus h minus fx over h. So yang atas ni kita kena let fx equal to x square plus 2x. Okay. And then so it is equal to limit h approaches to 0 fx plus h. So we substitute this x with x plus h, so x plus h power of 2 plus 2x plus h minus fx. So fx is x power of 2 plus 2x divided by h. So it is equal to limit h approaches to, okay, so expand this power of 2. So we have x square, x square plus 2hx plus h square, and then positive 2 we expand, so become plus 2x plus 2h, and then this negative expand minus x square minus 2x over h. And then okay, so dalam ni boleh simplifykan lagi tak? Okay, so tak ada lah, sini x square, this one 2hx, h square plus 2x plus 2h. So it is equal to limit h approaches to 0 x square minus x square, cancel, and then plus 2hx. Okay, so 2hx, and then plus h square, and then plus 2x minus 2x, 0, and then plus 2h over h. Saya tak buka kurungan tapi dah boleh potong-potong ke? Boleh. Sebab ni kurungan ni untuk selesaikan dalam ni. Tapi dalam ni kita dah tak ada apa-apa nak selesaikan lah, sebab dia punya term sendiri dah berbeza. So this one x square, this one hx, this one h square, this one x, and this one h. Tak ada yang sama. Okay? Okay, so bila tak ada yang sama, bracket tu kita boleh buka terus je. Okay, so tak, dah tak ada apa nak disimplifikan. Okay? Okay, so then from here we have h, here also we have h, and here also we have h. So therefore we can factorize h. So it is equal to limit h approaches to 0, so factorize h. Okay, so h dekat luar, so yang ni h, first one is already outside, so the only left is 2x, then this one on left is positive h, and for this one is positive 2 over h. Okay, so we can simplify this one. Okay, so jangan potong dengan yang ni, yang ni tambah. Okay, so sini darab. Okay, so kita tengok apa darab apa. Okay, so mana yang sama. Okay, so kita tengok bracket ni dengan h sama tak. Okay, so bracket ni 2x tambah h tambah 2 semua sekali. So kalau nak cancel semua sekali dengan yang bawah. Tapi sebab semua sekali ni tak sama dengan h, so kita tak boleh nak cancel apa-apa. Okay, so yang sebelah sini, ha, ni h sahaja. Okay, so h dengan h, ha, kita boleh simplify. So then, it is equal to limit h approaches to 0, 2x plus h plus 2. Okay, so as h approaches to 0, so this one becomes 0 lah. So the answer is 2x plus 2. Okay, so this one is dy over dx. So dy over dx is equal to 2x plus 2. Okay, so gradient of the tangent at x equal to negative 3. Okay, so at x equal to negative 3 and y also is equal to 6. So tadi kita dah kira. Okay, so x negative 3, y dia 6. Okay, so compute kita dah dapat koordinat dia. Okay, so at x equal to negative 3, so dy over dx is equal to 2 times negative 3 plus 2. Okay, so ganti x, gantikan x dengan negative 3. So kita ada kat sini negative 6 plus 2, which is equal to negative 4. And then substitute into the equation of straight line lah. Okay, so okay, so sebab tangent garis lurus, so kita guna y equal to mx plus c. Okay, so m is the gradient of the tangent, which is this one, negative 4. So y equal to negative 4x plus c. Okay, so to find c, so we use the coordinate here. So koordinat yang kita dah ada ni, kita guna untuk cari point c. So y 6, negative 4, x is negative 3 plus c. So 6 is equal to negative 4 times negative 3, positive 12 plus c. Okay, so 6 minus 12 is equal to c. So c is equal to negative 6. Okay, and then write down again the equation of the tangent. Okay, equation of the tangent. Y is equal to m negative 4x plus c. So c is negative 6. Okay, so inilah persamaan dia. Okay. Okay, so another example. Okay, so find the equation of the tangent to the curve y equal to e to x over square root 1 minus 2x at 0, 1. Okay, so sekarang kita dah ada koordinat. Cukuplah. Okay, so dah ada x, dah ada y. Ya, tak perlu nak cari nilai y. So bila koordinat kita dah ada, so kita boleh terus proceed to find gradient of the tangent. Okay, so find the dy over dx. Okay, so y sekarang ni dalam bentuk u over v. Okay, so if you have form, so u bahagi v, so ni atas ni bahagi dengan yang bawah. Okay, so to find the dy over dx, so we need to use quotient rule. Okay, so u is equal to e to x. Okay, so therefore u prime is equal to e to x. Okay, so differentiate exponent, dia akan dapat benda yang sama, and then multiply with derivative of the power. Okay, so bezakan kuasa dia, which is 2. So which is equal to 2 e to x. And then v, we have square root 1 minus 2x, which is 1 minus 2x power of 1 over 2. So v prime 1 over 2, 1 minus 2x power of 1 over 2 minus 1 is negative 1 over 2, times with derivative inside bracket this one. So 1 minus 2x derivative is negative 2. Okay, so sini darab, sini darab. Okay, so kita tengok 1, 2, 3. Okay, so yang kita darab ni, so kita boleh buat 1 per 2 darabkan dengan yang ni. Tapi ni semua dengan kuasa negatif 1 per 2 lah. So dia tak boleh masuk dalam lah, sebab ni kuasa negatif 1 per 2, yang ni kuasa 1. So yang ni negatif 2. So negatif 2 ni pun ni kuasa 1. So kita boleh darabkan dengan 1 per 2. Okay, so 1 per 2 darab negatif 2, which is negatif 1. So negatif 1 kita letak negatif je lah. Okay, so times with 1 minus 2x power of negative 1 over 2. Okay, so power of negative, so dia akan turun ke bawah. So which is equal to negative 1 over 1 minus 2x power of 1 over 2. Okay, so therefore dy over dx using quotient rule which is v u prime minus u v prime over v power of 2. So v, which is 1 minus 2 x power of 1 over 2, u prime, which is 2 e power of 2 x minus u, so u is e power of 2 x, and then times v prime, so v prime is negative 1 over 1 minus 2 x power of 1 over 2 over v power of 2. So v power of 2 is 1 minus 2 x square root power of 2. Okay. So kita tengok yang numerator dia, yang atas tu. So we have 1 minus 2 x power of 1 over 2. So we can write down as square root 1 minus 2 x. And then this one 2e to x. Okay, so 2 ni kita boleh letak depan. Okay, so sebelum tu saya tulis 2e to x tu kat depan lah, lagi mudah. So 2e power of 2x square root of 1 minus 2x. And then minus. Okay, so minus minus become positive. So plus e power of 2x. So e power of 2x ni kita boleh darabkan dengan 1. So sini darab. Okay, so negatif, darab negatif, positif. So e power of 2x times this fraction, pecahan ni. So kita boleh darabkan dengan atas. So e power of 2x times by 1, e power of 2x over square root of 1 minus 2x. And then over, so since e power of 2, so become 1 minus 2x. Okay, and then simplify. So yang depan ni per 1. Okay, so per 1, so we can make it same the denominator untuk combine dia. Sebab dia ni ada banyak layer lah ni. 1, 2, 3. So kalau boleh kita jadikan satu pecahan yang cantik lah sikit. So bawah ni darabkan dengan square root 1 minus 2x. Yang atas pun sama, darab dengan square root 2x. So we have here 2e power of 2x. So square root 1 minus 2x times square root 1 minus 2x. So only left 1 minus 2x. Then plus, so ni tadi dah. So plus e power of 2x. So over square root 1 minus 2x. Okay, so ini bahagi yang paling utama daripada atas tadi. So it become this one, divide by 1 minus 2x over 1. Yeah, so it is equal to 2e 2x. So kita expand 2e 2x times by 1 minus 2e 2x times 2x plus e power of 2x over square root 1 minus 2x. So here divide become multiplication. It is equal to 2e power of 2x plus e power of 2x. So dia sama, e 2x, e 2x. So sini 1, sini 2. So 2 tambah 1 jadi 3. So 3e power of 2x minus 2e 2x times 2x. So 2 times 2, 4. And then x, e power of 2x over square root 1 minus 2x times with 1 minus 2x. Okay. And then find the gradient of the tangent. Okay, so at point 0, 1, so dy over dx is equal to 3 e power of 2, x dia kosong, so 2 times 0, 0, minus 4 times 0, e power of 2 times by 0, 0, divide by square root 1 minus 2 times 0, okay, and then times with 1 minus 2 times 0. Okay. So the answer is 3 e power of 0 is 1, 3 times by 1 is 3, minus 4 times 0, 0, and then 0 times anything, 0 lah, divide by square root 1 minus 2 times 0, so 0, 1 minus 0, 1 lah, square root 1, and this one 1 minus 2 times 0, okay, jawapannya 1. Okay, so the answer is 3 minus 0 is 3, so square root 1 is 1, 1 times by 1 is 1. So gradient dia 3. Okay. And then substitute into the formula of straight line. So y is equal to m x plus c. So gradient dia 3, so gantikanlah. Okay. And then use the point coordinate 0 1. Okay, so to find the value of c. So 1 is equal to 3 times by 0 plus c. So 3 times 0, 0 lah. So 0 plus c is c. So therefore c is equal to 1. Okay, so equation of tangent. Is y equal to 3x plus 1. Okay, so dah siap. Okay. Okay, so next second derivative. Okay, so second derivative, what is it actually? Okay, so first differentiation, we call it as first derivative. Okay, so then second derivative, this one actually is the differentiation of dy over dx. Okay, so daripada first derivative ni, kita differentiate lagi sekali, so kita akan dapat second derivative. Okay. So second derivative, d square y over dx square, so simbol dia, d square y over dx square is the differentiation of the first derivative. Okay, so differentiate first with respect to x. Okay, so first derivative tadi, differentiate y respect to x. Second derivative, differentiate dy over dx respect to x. So maksudnya second derivative ni kita differentiatekan kali ke 2. Okay. So contoh. So given y equal to x power of 3 minus 5x plus 1 over x. Okay, so first kat sini ada 1 over x. So 1 over x ni kalau ada over tu kita buat naikkan ke atas x power of negative 1. Okay, so the question need us to find second derivative, d square y over dx square. So therefore, from y equal to x cube of x plus x power of negative 1. So first, we search dy over dx. Okay. So mula-mula kita cari dulu dy over dx. Okay, so dy over dx meaning that differentiate y respect to x. Okay, so differentiate this one respect to x. So we have 3x power of 2 minus by 5 plus negative 1 times with x negative 1 minus 1. So which is 3x square minus 5 minus x power of negative 2. Okay. And then differentiate this one again to obtain second derivative. Okay, so differentiate first derivative respect to x. Okay, so this one first derivative. Okay, so second derivative, differentiate the first derivative respect to x. So 2 times by 3, 6, x, 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay, so differentiate 5, 0, nothing. And then this one, minus. So negative 2 bring in front. X, negative 2 minus 1 become negative 3. So therefore, we have 6x plus 2x power of negative 3. Okay, so it is equal to 6x plus 2 over x power of 3. Okay, so plus a negative, kita boleh bawa turun ke bawah. Yeah, so another example. Okay, so we have fx equal to 3x minus 2 power of 3 times with 2x power of 2. So find their second derivative. Okay, so we have fx. Okay, so fx ni dalam bentuk uv. Okay, so dalam bentuk darab. Sini darab. Okay, so sini tengah-tengah ni darab. Okay, so which is 3x minus 2 power of 3 darabkan dengan 2x power of 2. Okay, nah, bentuk darab. So uv. Okay, so this one, so therefore this one need to use product rule in order to find the first derivative. Okay, so u is 3x minus 2 power of 3. Okay, so u is equal to 3x minus 2 power of 3. So u prime, it is equal to 3 bring in front. Okay, so 3 ni bawa depan. 3x minus 2 power of 3 minus 1 which is 2. And then differentiate inside 3x minus 2 ni. Okay, so differentiate yang dalam ni iaitu 3x tolak 2 which is 3. Okay, so 3 times by 3, 9. 3x minus 2 power of 2. And then v, so v we have 2x power of 2. Okay, so 2 bring in front. So we have 2 times with 2x power of 2 minus 1 become 1. And then differentiate inside. So differentiate 2x we have 2. So 2 times by 2 is 4. And then times with 2x power of 1. So ni kuasa 1, 4 ni pun kuasa 1. So therefore kita boleh darabkan 4 dengan 2x. So 4 times 2x become 8x. Okay, so si, okay, so kita dah ada dia punya u, v, u prime and v prime. So then we can find the first derivative. Okay, so first derivative, it is equal to u v prime. So u is 3x minus 2 power of 3, v plus 8x, and then plus v u prime. So v is 2x power of 2, v u prime is 9, 3x minus 2 power of 2. Okay, so then we have here 8x, 3x minus 2 power of 3 plus 2x power of 2 is 9. 9 boleh letak depan. Okay, so ni nombor 9 kita letak depan. So 9, 2x power of 2, 3x minus 2 power of 2. Okay, and then permudahkan dulu. So here we have 9x minus 2 power of 2. Sini ada kuasa 3, 2. Ini kuasa dia 3. So kita boleh bawa keluar yang kuasa 2. So we have 3x minus 2 power of 2. So dalam dia tinggal 8x. So sini kita dah bawa keluar kuasa 2. So kat sini tinggal 3x tolak 2 tambah 9. Okay, so yang ni kita dah keluarkan semua, dah hilang lah. So tinggal yang ni. So 2x kuasa 2 ni kita boleh kuasakan teruslah. 2 power of 2 which is 4. And then x power of 2 is x square. Okay, so it is equal to 3x minus 2 power of 2. Okay, so this 8x we can expand. Okay, so sebab di sini kuasa 1, sini pun semua ni kuasa 1. Kuasa dia sama. So kita boleh expand. So kat sini kita tak boleh expand lah. Sini kuasa 3, yang sini ni kuasa 1. So selepas kita faktorkan tadi, kuasa dia dah sama, 1-1. Okay, so 24x kali x, x kuasa 2. Then 8x times with negative 2, so negative 16x plus 9 times 4x square. Esa ni kuasa 2. Kuasa 2 ni dekat x. Semua ni sekali kuasa dia 1. 9 ni kuasa 1. Okay, so 4 ni kuasa 1. So 9 kita boleh darabkan dengan 4. So 9 times with 4, which is 36. So 36 x power of 2. And then we have 3x minus 2 power of 2, 24x square plus 36. The answer is 60. Okay, so 60x power of 2 minus 16x. Okay, so this one, first derivative. Okay, so for the second derivative, so again, so this one, u, and this one, v. Okay, so u darab v, okay? Okay, so u prime, it is equal to, okay, so u is equal to 3x minus 2 power of 2. So u prime, 2 bring in front, so 2, 3x minus 2 power of 2 minus 1 is 1. And then differentiate inside, which is 3. So we have 6, 3x minus 2. And then here we have v. V which is equal to 60x square minus 16x. So v prime is equal to 2 bring in front, 120x minus 16. Okay, so dah dapat semua tu, kita buat second derivative. F double prime x. So which is equal to u v prime. So u which is 3x minus 2 power of 2, v prime which is 120x minus 16, plus v u prime. So v is 60x square. Tak muat pula. Sekejap eh. Okay, so f prime x, it is equal to u v prime 3x minus 2 square 120x minus plus v u prime, so 60x square minus 16x u prime 6 3x minus 2. So this one 3x, here also 3x. Okay, so kita boleh factor out, boleh keluarkan yang kuasa 1 lah. Okay, so 3x tolak 2, yang ni kuasa 1. So yang gagal, 3x tolak 2 kuasa 1. So here 120x minus 16 plus, okay, so 6 bawa depan, 6, 60x square minus 16x. Yang ni kita dah keluarkan, so tinggal yang ni sahaja. So it is equal to 3x minus 2. Okay, so this one expand, sebab sini kuasa 1, kuasa 1 sama. So you can expand 3 times 120x. Okay, so the answer is 326x square. And then 3x times 16, so minus 36, 18, 48. So 48x. Then negative 2 times 120x, negative 240x, negative 2 times negative 16, positive 32. So this one also we can expand. Okay, so 6 times 60, 360x square, and then minus 6 times 16x, which is 92. X, okay. Okay. Okay, so then it is equal to 3x minus 2, 360x square. Okay, so 360x square plus 360x square, 720x square. And then negative 48x minus 240x minus 92x. Berapa jawapan dia ni? So negative 48 minus 240, negative 288x plus 32 minus 92x. Okay, so saya kira satu-satu, okay. 3x minus 2, 720x square minus 288 minus 92, 80 1 10 380. Okay, so -380x. Okay. And then plus 32. Okay, so inilah jawapannya. Okay, so panjang jalan kiri dia ya. Okay. So, kalau produk kena dekat produk tu dia panjang lah. So konsep dia gitulah. Second derivative ni kita bezakan derivatif yang pertama. Okay. Okay, so kalau kena dekat product rule, terpaksalah pakai product rule. Kalau kena dekat quotient rule, kena pakai quotient rule. Dan seterusnya. Okay, so that's all for our lesson today. So see you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.